Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you how to add inline code directly inside your Logic App. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. In a project I'm working on right now, I needed to manipulate some string inside the Logic App. I could have created an Azure function and do my work over there, but there's a new functionality named Code Inline that gives me that opportunity. So let me show you. Here I have a very simple Logic App, and because it's a demo, I will keep the recurrence every 3 months. What I want to do is read that file here, simple notes, that contain a string, and at the end of the string, between square brackets, I have tags. So I want to extract those tags and make two different strings. To do it, what I will do is first read that file. So I will need to use the OneDrive connector. There it is. And I want to read the content of the file. So here I have a get file content just here. So if it's not done yet, you will need to authorize Logic App to access your OneDrive folder. And then you will be able to select the file. And simple note, just here. Perfect. So now let's add one variable just for fun. I will explain later what we'll be using it for. So initialize, I will call that variable clean note, and I will set it as an object. Great. So now let's save it. For Code Inline to be able to access the workflow properties, I need the integration account. So let's add one first. To create one of those accounts, it's very simple. Click in the top left corner of your screen, the green button, and then search for integration. You have integration account. You click here, you click the blue button, create. You fill that form, and after just a few seconds, you have your new account. Now let's go back to the Logic App. So now I'm in the Logic App. I need to assign this integration account to my Logic App. It's very simple. You go in the left panel in the properties, and you select the workflow settings. And here, integration account. You just need to pick it. For me, it was already selected. Don't forget to save. And now you can continue to edit your Logic App. So go back in the Logic App Designer or through the overview, click the Edit button. So now we are ready to add the code. So let's look for it. And here we have it, inline code. At the moment I'm recording this video, it's only execute JavaScript code and it's in preview, but it's working very well. Because the window is a little bit small, let me show the code in my Visual Studio Code Editor. So here it is. You will see it's very simple. So on the first line, what I do is create a variable named note, and I will go access the workflow context. And this context has access to the actions and trigger. In my case, I want to access the action named getFileContent. I will show you later where that name comes from. And then from the output, I want the body. That will result exactly at the content of the file. So after that, it's just JavaScript. So I will create a variable to identify the last location of the square brackets. Then I create an empty object and assign the property where I will be doing a substring, like extracting part of the string. So now let's copy that in Logic App. Great. Let's save it. And there it is. So remember that name, getFileContent? Well, it's from here. All spaces are replaced by underscores. And if you're not sure, you can always go in the code view. Because remember, a Logic App is in fact a big JSON file. And then you will see in the actions, you will be able to find your getFileContent available. Now let's go back in Designer, and remember that variables I created. Now let's assign the result of our inline code to that variable. So new step, then variables. I will do a set variables. I'm picking my clean note and I will assign the result. If for some reason the result properties is not available, you can always add it manually. Remember, you go in the code view and you will be able to add the execute JavaScript code body. It will look exactly like this. Outputs, and then between parentheses, execute JavaScript code or the name that you gave if you renamed it, and body. The interrogation point here is just to specify maybe the body is empty. Great. Now we have all we need. Let's run it. Don't forget to save. And now let's run it. Of course, it's a very simple logic app, so it will take only a few seconds. Voila! So now if we have a look, we'll see that the code was executed and we have a property, so just the tags here and just the message here. And if we look again in the variables, of course, it's the same settings. This way you will be able to add code directly inside your logic app without having to create and deploy Azure Functions or APIs. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon. This way you will receive a notification every time I publish a new Cloud in 5 Minutes video. If you want to know more about logic app, you can watch those videos. Thank you for watching. See you next time. The interrogator. The inter. Huh? The inter. Huh?